Now, everybody wants success, correct? The main thing why you came in this course or why you do anything in your life regarding to work is basically to get success. Now, that success can be in term of relationships, health, wealth, anything, right? Everyone wants success. And success needs one big thing, which is called as transformation. How many of you agree with me over here that the one thing you need to become successful is basically learn transformation? Transformation of your thoughts, transformation of yourself and all these things, correct? Now, what is the number one factor behind transformation? What do you think? Why transformation happens? What is the first thing that you need to do to transform yourself? What's the first thing that you need to do to transform yourself? Now, this becomes tricky, right? What's the first thing that you need to do to transform yourself? Communication, change mindset, okay, discipline. Okay, what else? Consistency. Okay, so consistency, I would not say. Seek help. Yeah, seek help is a good one. To accept the change. Okay, acceptance. But that's not the first thing. Okay, the number one thing that will make you transform in anything, maybe your fitness, maybe your health, maybe your money, maybe your relationships, anything, is the word CON. So it's a long word, but I'll write the short form. It's consciousness. The number one thing that will help you transform in any of the field that you desire to be is consciousness. What is consciousness? It's basically awareness. Until and unless you're not aware that you need to get transformed about something, how can you transform yourself? Got it? So the number one thing that you need to focus in consciousness. Now, who can define consciousness for me in the chat? What is consciousness according to you? For me, it's like, in one word, I would say awareness. But for a better definition, what would you say? Self-awareness, good. Awareness, good. Everything we do, correct. Right, so everything we do is basically consciousness. That only difference between animals and humans is humans are conscious, right? They understand what is going on and how they act upon it and how they can take feedback and change things. They know about it. That's why we are different as human species and not like any other plant or animal, right? Because we are conscious. Now, who remembers the week two? What week two is about? Week two is all about consciousness if you look it closely. Because what we are doing is we are making you fill worksheets to make you self-aware. To make you aware, right? If you see, every worksheet has three questions. Not every, but most of them, which is, what is your niche? What is your current situation? What is your desired situation? Am I correct? Now, you would be thinking, why this person is asking the same question again and again in all these worksheets? The simple reason is to make you aware. Because you write it down one, and you feel you have basically become aware of it. But believe me, you haven't. Simple example of this. If right now I want to prove it, what is your goal for this month now? If you even took more than 1 second to answer this question, you were not aware of the goal. And chances are, you will not reach the goal. If you took more than 1 second to answer that thing. Right? And you need to be honest with yourself, because all progress starts with truth. Right? For all of those who were not able to write their goal or get it in 1 second, you got my point. Right? You were not very aware of the goal. That's why reaching it was a big problem. Because you are not conscious about the goal, you are not conscious about the process, you are not conscious about the things that are happening around you, due to which it creates a conflict between your brain and the path. Got it? Let me show you something. This is my basically goal diary, right? It has been filled fully, a little bit pages remaining, and you see, I write my goals twice every day. Twice every day. And not me, every of my team member does that. Every of my team member. Now just imagine writing it two times a day, one after waking up and one before sleeping, how conscious you become about the goal. And once you become more conscious, would transformation happen or not? Would it happen the first time? Maybe not. But second, third, fourth, fifth, at one time in 1 month of a year, you will get it and you'll be like, yes, I transformed myself. Got it? So that is basically consciousness. And week two, we cover all about that thing, and that's why week two is over there. Most people believe week two is the most boring week, but believe me, week two is the most important week that you can ever go in any course. Because all those courses, what they're doing, that you may have attended, is basically not make you self-aware of who you are and why that coach and who you are is important, but what they do is just give you tactics key. Here is the funnel template, here is the webinar template, here is the call template, and all these things, and just go and apply. and that's why they have a 1% success rate. But if you see in this community, we have over 25% success rate. And by 25% above, I mean people who have made 1 lakh and above. Right? So it's 25%, which is very high compared to any other thing you would see outside. And if you see the completion thing, it's kind of 100%. Right? So that is basically the consciousness, and week 2 is basically covering that part. Now, if consciousness starts to develop, what would be affected the most? If your consciousness starts to develop with time, what is affected the most? Change in everything? Okay, but what it starts with, the first thing that is changed when your consciousness changes. Okay, so let's say you were sleeping. Let me tell you. So let's say you were sleeping, right? And you woke up. So you became conscious. When you're sleeping, you were not that much conscious. But when you woke up, you're thinking, okay, you're getting Simran, you are close. So when you woke up, what is the first thing? Like, when your urge of that waking up, what is the first thing that raises or that gets affected? Be more active. Your thinking is kind of right answer. Ramde, mindset. Mindset is a very vague term. I want you to go specific. So the word is nothing but psychology. Correct? The first thing that changes is your psychology. Because the moment you were on the urge, it was your psychology which changed, which made you like, "Haan, theek hai, main uth chuka," and you wake up. Right? The first thing that changes is psychology. Correct? What is now basically this psychology? Let's cover the psychology part. What is basically psychology? How? What is psychology according to you? Definition of psychology. Not the Google one, huh? Don't Google it. Method of thinking, correct. So it's how you perceive. What is your perception of this world? That is your psychology. Right? Now tell me, do rich people perceive the world differently and you and people who are not rich perceive the world differently? Yeah, mentality is the correct word, Shubha. Right? Rich people have a different perception of the world and broke people have a different perception of the world. The rich may be looking opportunity at something and the poor may be crying about that same thing. Right? There's a difference in perception. Now you see how consciousness affects your success rate. Right. If you just want to know about this, what you can do is Google consciousness relation with success. Like you can Google this kind of thing and you'll get a whole big articles which are written about this. And this is research proven that the number one thing that affects your success rate is your consciousness. How conscious you are. And basically, if you go deep. Now, let me cover this also. So this little bit off the topic, but let's say we'll cover anyways. So consciousness come into four facets. How to raise your consciousness, you need to first understand what is consciousness. It comes into four facets. The first facet is organization. Organization means organizing your thoughts, organizing your work, organizing your desk, organizing everything that you do. Right? Let me show you my desktop. This is how my desktop looks like. You see, everything is organized. I show you my Google Drive, it's organized. Everything that I show is organized. The simple reason is because consciousness needs first thing, which is organization. The second thing that consciousness works on is known as prudence. Now, prudence is hard work, right? In normal language, it's called as hard work, right? So if you think hard work is only key to success, it's not. It's only 25% of the equation because there are four more things that are in this lane. Right, so hard work is only the 25% part. And if you're thinking that only this will help you to get off the barrier, I'm sorry, but that's only 1/4 of the equation. Right? If that was the case, that hard work is 100% responsible for success, construction workers and laborers would be the richest people right now in the planet. But you see, that's not the case. The next part, so it's prudence, or basically what you can say is hard work. Hope you're taking notes on this. Now, the next one is basically perfectionism, right? What they follow is known as Six Sigma. All the corporate trainers right now, they would be understanding this concept very well. What is Six Sigma? You have 3 defects per million. Only 3 defects per million. So, if you basically, so what you need to do is basically things that are very important, you need to be double checking them. If you see when the pilots, let's say the pilots, they are getting ready to take off the plane. What they are doing is hydraulics, check. Brake, check. work on check, engine check. What they're doing is double checking everything, right? So the chances of a plane failing or getting crashed or having some kind of error is kind of zero, because the pilots are being taught to be perfectionists, so that the thing has 6 defects per million, which now basically creates a chance of you having success. And it's not every time, right? It's when it's important, you can become a perfectionist. And the last thing which is very important is basically decision making, right? Now I'll let you understand what is that. What is happening is, people are working hard, people are organized, and people are doing it in a very perfectionist manner. The only problem is the compass in their mind is wrong. So let's say I have a compass right now, right? And this is the north, this is the true north. But the society has conditioned me, has programmed me from the beginning, that, and they have rotated my compass. So now, according to my brain compass, that is north, but the true north is that. So let's say I want to reach to that bag, and that bag is, let's say, 1 mile from here, and I have my compass, and the first thing, let's say I became conscious that I need to become successful, I need to become a better virgin, right? I see that bag, that's north, right? And I'm like, okay, I can go over there. So what I do is, I take off my compass and I see that, but it's pointing north, that side, right? I know that's north, and let's say I cannot see the bag. So I know I just need to go to the north, and I take out my compass and I see north is backwards. So I see back and I'm like, okay, that's backwards. So what you do is, now since you are hardwired that you need to do a lot of hard work, what you do is you rotate, and since Earth is 24,000 miles, you get 23,999 miles back, and you come backside of that bag, you will reach the goal. There's no doubt that you'll never reach the goal. You will reach the goal. But the problem is you took a long enough time.
Now, mere bhai, if you liked this conversation and this video, I'm 100% sure you like different videos of mine as well. Now, don't subscribe to the channel. Go to my channel, check out all the videos. If you find value, then click on the subscribe button and the notification icon.